vertical line, means broadside on position. But one mistake from my side, that calculation, you check it again. Suppose you consider it two charges, one is the negative and another is the positive. They create a small distance in electric dipole, very, very small distance. Suppose you consider this is the A and that is the B. From the center of this unit, positive charge is placed on that position here. So, if this distance is R, that distance will be R minus L, and from here that distance will be R plus L. Okay, my dear student? Now we find out the electric field at the point of P. Electric field at the point of P. Due to the charge plus, due to the charge plus, that means you can write here, if you write it the vectorial form, then you must use the arrow sign. If you write it the scalar form, means magnitude, then you cannot write this vectorial sign. Suppose you consider first, you consider this is the vectorial sign. Due to the charge plus, so what will be the Q by R minus L whole square? Okay, Q by R square, R minus L whole square. What will be its direction? Q into, suppose you consider this is the unit vector I, means the direction will be B to P. Due to the plus charge, they are repelled to each other, so direction will be this. Due to the minus charge, that will be Q the direction will be this. P to B. Okay? You check here. So, now we consider E equal to E1 plus E2. Which one is more? This value is less, so that value is more. This value is more, so that value is less. Okay? E plus minus E minus. Okay? One by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q minus I by R plus L whole square. Okay? So that value will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. This is equal to Q one by R minus L whole square plus, this is minus, this is the plus minus Q by 1 by r minus l plus l r whole square. This is equal to 1 by 4 minus l. That is equal to q by I into 4 r into l by r square minus l square whole square. Okay? This direction is I 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 p r by r square minus l square whole square into unit vector I. That means the direction is the positive x axis. That means this direction, the direction of the E, direction of E is B to P. Okay. Now, what will be the magnitude of this? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 P R by R square minus L square whole square. If R is greater than L, then the value will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into 2 pi r by r square minus l square whole square. This is the expression for the axial line or the end on position. Now, we calculate the equatorial line or broadside on position. Equatorial line. Second part. Equatorial line means if you consider the two charges are here, one is the minus q, one is the minus q, and another is the plus q. They creates the electric dipole. Equatorial lines means this is the axis. It is the center. Means the line passing through the center of the electric dipole and perpendicular through that point. That is the equatorial line. This distance is 2L. So that distance is L. You consider here a unit positive charge at the point of P, from the midpoint or the center of this point, the distance of the positive charge R. So this distance is the hypotenuse, so it will be the R square plus L square. The distances are same, so that distance will be R square plus L square. Okay, so due to the negative charge, here is positive charge, they are repel and attract, they will attract to each other. So this direction is the E minus. Clear? Yes. And rub it. Now continue it. So plus sign. This is the plus sign. So due to the plus charge, they are repelled to each other, that is the E plus. So the resultant vector, that means the resultant field, the direction will be this from your vector formula. If this angle is theta, that angle also the theta, and according to your geometry, this angle theta, that angle theta. So this angle will be 2 theta. That is the direction of A. Clear, dear my student? It is electric dipole, plus charge and minus charge are here, and the distance between the electric dipole will be 2L. Line passing through the center of the electric dipole and perpendicular on it, the distance from the center R, a point is P, unit charge is there. Due to this unit charge, minus charge attract to that unit charge and the direction will be E minus, and the plus sign, plus charge will repel to each other and the direction will be on what the line, okay. So the two vectors, one is this direction, another is that direction. So the resultant will be middle of it because both are the values are same. Am I clear? So now we find out the resultant vector, that means the direction of the electric field due to the electric dipole. Okay. So first we find out the value of E plus. What will be its direction? Suppose this is the C and that is the D and that is the R. So E plus, what will be its value? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by AP square. What will be its direction? The direction will be P to D. The direction will be P to D. Okay. E minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by B to P. What will be its direction? The direction will be P to B. P to C, P C. Okay. The two vectors, that is the this and that. So direction is this and that. The values are same. So what will be its magnitude? What will be its resultant vector? You know it. Resultant vector E equal to E plus E minus. Okay. Find out its magnitude from your previous class. You know it, vector rule. What will be its magnitude? The value of R equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos theta. You know it. Means the resultant vector R, A and B are the magnitude of the two vectors and angle makes the angle two vectors theta. That time this. So what will be value of E equal to under root of E plus S square E minus S square plus 2 E plus E minus cos of 2 theta. Okay. So if you consider it, both are same. Both are same. So you can write it E. So write here the values. 1 plus cos 2 theta, what is its formula? You know it. What is its formula? 2 cos square theta. So, we can write here, equal to 2e plus cos of theta. 2e plus means magnitude of this, means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square, means that is r square plus l square. Under root of square means this, cos theta equal to l by under root of r square plus l square equal to 2 q into l by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square plus l square whole to the power 3 by 2. That is equal to p by 2 pi epsilon naught into r square plus l square whole to the power 3 by 2. If r is greater than l, then the value of E will be P by 2 pi epsilon naught into R cube. You check it. And this is the derivation for that. Okay. For the axial condition, you know the derivation. E equal to 2 P by 4 pi epsilon naught into R cube. For the equatorial position, E equal to P by 4 pi epsilon naught into R cube. So, you check it and you derive it, and if you put it in any angle, not the equatorial, not the axial, that time the derivation will be different, you try it. Okay. Next part. Torque on a dipole due to uniform electric field. Suppose you consider the uniform electric field. This is the uniform electric field. Those lines are parallel. The direction of the field is this. An electric dipole is placed inside the electric field. If the electric dipole is rotated at an angle theta, okay, you check it, electric dipole is here, plus q and minus q charge, and they are separated at a distance 2L inside a uniform electric field. Due to the rotation of the electric dipole at an angle theta, we calculate the torque of that electric dipole. Okay, if this angle equal to theta, that angle also be the theta. So, if the charge is here and due to the field E, the force equal to F equal to Q into E, you know it. So, due to the plus charge, that value will be plus QE and that is the minus QE. And two forces are there, the net forces will be zero, because those are same, but in opposite direction. Okay, so they creates a torque, you know it. They creates a couple, they creates a dipole. Okay, so that couple, due to the moment of that couple, you find out it. So force is here and that side is here. So you consider a perpendicular line on it, and what is the value of? What is the value of torque? Torque equal to, you know it. Torque equal to, okay, you write first this. Torque equal to force into perpendicular distance between the distance. So F into perpendicular distance. Suppose you consider this is the A and that is the B and that is the C. Okay. So perpendicular distance means AC. What is the value of force? Q into E. AC means you know the value of AB. So you find out the value of AC with respect to AB. So that will be the AB sin theta. Okay. Means height by hypotenuse. Q into E into AB means 2L sin theta. So 2L into Q into A sin theta. That value will be P into E into sin theta. That is equal to torque. If you write it in the vectorial form, that equal to P cross E. Okay. Vectorial form of the torque is P cross E. That means torque is a vector quantity. Torque is a vector quantity. What will be its direction? So you know it. P cross E means P is this direction, E is that direction. The direction will be clockwise. You check it. So the direction will be tau inward the board. Am I clear, yes or no? If you consider the E to P, the direction is onward the board. But when you consider the P to E, the direction is inward the board. Inward the board. You must sense here what will be its direction. Am I clear? What will be its unit and dimension? Unit. The unit will be, suppose you write it in the scalar form, that will be tau equal to P into E into sin theta. So P means electric dipole. Electric dipole moment, what is its unit? P equal to 2L into Q means coulomb into meter. What will be its E? E means electric field. Newton into E means F by Q. That means Newton by coulomb. Newton by coulomb. So you cancel in Newton into meter. That is equal to Newton into meter means joule. Am I clear? You find out the dimension of it. So what will be its dimension? What will be its dimension? How can we find out it? the dimension of E. What will be the dimension of E? What will be its dimension of E? Dimension of E equal to force by Coulomb. Force by Coulomb means ML T to the power minus 2 by Coulomb means A into T. ML T to the power minus 3 A to the power minus 1. E into, if you try to write it, Newton into meter. E, P equal to, P means 2L into Q, A into T. Q means A into T. That value will be, so we can write here, tau equal to ML T to the power minus 3 A to the power minus 1. L into AT. L means M L square T to the power minus 2. That is the joule. Otherwise, you can find out it. You can also find out it. You write it directly as your wish from your unit, tau equal to, the unit of tau equal to Newton into meter. Newton means force, ML T to the power minus 2 into L, that is ML square T to the power minus 2. If you drive it, this is the method, or if you drive it, that is also the method, but if you write it according to the your remembering method, tau is the work done. So, work done equal to ML square T to the power minus 2. Okay. Now, we see when it will be stable, unstable, when it will be stable and unstable. This is the question for your board exam, when it will be stable and unstable. Suppose you consider, you know it, if this line, that means the line of the electric dipole and electric field are same. That time the electric field direction will be negative to positive and electric dipole the direction will be negative and positive, negative to positive. So, it will be stable. How can you find out it? So, first time you consider when theta equal to 0 degree, because you know it, the value of tau equal to P into E into sin theta. Okay. Theta equal to 0 degree, sin 0 equal to 0. Sin 0 equal to 0. That time tau equal to 0. Stable means equilibrium. Equilibrium condition. When you consider theta equal to 90 degree, that sin 90 equal to 1, tau equal to q into a. It will be the maximum value. When you see theta equal to 180 degree, sin 100 t equal to 0. That time tau equal to 0, but the position of the electric dipole is this, so anti-clockwise, means this is the unstable condition. Okay, you remember it, this is the 1 marks or 2 marks question for your board exam, when it will be stable and when it will be unstable, and why it will be stable and why it will be unstable. Okay, next part area vector. Most complicated term, you know it from your previous class. Area is a scalar quantity, but you consider here area is a vector quantity. But you consider here area is a vector quantity. You consider this area. Area has no direction. So, area is a scalar quantity, but in this chapter, in this part, from this, you know the area is a vector quantity. Area also control the electric charge. How the area will control the electric charge? Suppose you consider it. You consider this is a transparent tube. Passing through the transparent tube, the water will be passing through the transparent tube and the motion will be streamlined. Okay. Suppose you put a cork inside this tube and cork will control the flow of water. That time, when you lock it, that is the surface of it. It will be locked. That means water will not flow through the, does not flow through the tube. Suppose you consider the charged particle will flow through this surface. And that must be the perpendicular on it. So, it has a direction. When the direction and magnitudes are there, that time we consider it is a vector quantity. So, area is a vector quantity, the direction must be perpendicular on that surface. Okay. And next is electric flux. Electric flux, you consider an area vector or a surface enclosed by the charged particle. The magnetic lines of force, the electric lines of force passing through this surface perpendicularly, that surface, that means electric lines of force passing through the surface. The total number of electric field lines passing through that surface means you consider a surface, the total number of electric field lines passing through that surface, that is the electric flux. Electric flux is denoted by the phi. It is the product of the electric field and the dot product of the electric field and the area vector. That means the surface area of that. That means the Gaussian surface. You know the next time the Gaussian surface. Electric flux, it is the dot product. So, it is the scalar quantity. What is its unit? What is its dimension? What is its unit and what is its dimension? You consider it. How can we find out it? Suppose you consider it, the direction of the ds is this. Okay? The direction of the E is that. So, this angle is theta. So, along this direction, that component will be E cos theta. Okay? So, it is the product of those. That means, phi equal to E ds into cos theta. That means, E dot ds. Suppose you consider it, this is the direction and that is the direction. So, if you try to write it in the unit vector, that means the n or s, and that is the s, this is the s and that is the n. So those are the dot product, the value of the n and s equal to 1. So what will be its unit? What will be its unit? Unit phi equal to, what will be the unit of E? E equal to F by C. Newton per coulomb or volt per meter, as you wish. So if you write it Newton per coulomb or volt per meter, you write it the volt per meter into meter square, that is volt into meter. Or if you write it this, that is equal to Newton per coulomb into meter square. Newton per coulomb into meter square. How can we find out its? How can we find out its dimension? You try to write it, it's find out the dimension. Okay. Next part, just 2 minutes. Next part is the Gauss theorem. Next part is the Gauss theorem. Gaussian surface, Gauss theorem. Gauss theorem, you know it, the total flux, total electric field through any closed surface in free space. Total electric flux through any surface in free space is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught time of the electric charge. Okay. 1 by phi equal to q by epsilon naught, means 1 by epsilon naught times of the electric charge. Or you write it here, if you write it in this form, d phi equal to surface integration of E dot ds equal to q by epsilon naught. How can we prove it? How can we prove it? So, phi equal to q by epsilon naught. From this derivation, we can find out it. Suppose you consider a small area d phi, the electric flux is equal to total surface integration of E dot ds, means E into d into, means if the direction of the ds is this and the direction of the field is also that time the theta equal to 0 degree, cos 0 equal to 1. So we can write here the S E into ds. So E is outside this integration sign ds. What will be the surface integration ds? Ds means 4 pi r square. What will be the value of E? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square into 4 pi r square. You cancel it. That is equal to q by epsilon naught phi equal to integration. So you can write here the phi, that also continue with this, then that value will be that. This is the proof for this theorem. The application also, you try to prove it. Uniformly state where you find out the electric field. Suppose you consider a state uniformly long state where charged by the uniformly. Okay, so you try to complete it. Those are the homework. And interesting part is this. This side is the ds and that side is the e, but this side is the ds and that side is the e. And that side is the ds and this side will be the e. So those are 90 degree cancel to each other. Only this value is theta degree. So you calculate this part and you find out the value of electric field for the state conductor. So today, thank you, my student. I am waiting for next day. You must be clear, and if any problem, you clear next day also. Okay. How many minutes? How many minutes?